I'm going to show you a calendar app that's going to blow your freaking mind away. And no, this is not BS. Well, basically, Vimcal contacted me. Hey, you know what? I want you to make a video of Vimcal. And I'm like, okay, let's do it. But before that, someone in the team asked me that they wanted to make a meeting with me. They wanted to show me Vimcal and how it worked. The first thing that came to my mind is like, how cool or how many features can a calendar app have? And basically, that was my first thought. And to make a long story short, when that meeting was over, and that was with Alex, I was with my jaw drop open. It was like, whoa, that is cool. Basically, I think this was made for me. And like I said, this is not BS. I'm really excited to show you this calendar app. And if you want to sign up, you need to request access as of now, okay? So let's go get started with this and check it out. The calendar app that I want to show you is called the Vimcal. And let's get started with the most juicy part about it. Like I said, I think that this calendar app was actually made for me. Why? Because I hate calendar apps that force you to add a schedule to your life. Okay, what do I mean by that? Me, I don't want to have a schedule open for someone to book a meeting from Monday to Friday from 9 a.m. to 2 p.m. and then from 4 p.m. to 8 p.m. all week, okay, or just by several days. I want a flexible calendar that works with me, and this gives me that access, okay? So I want to get started with this most juicy part about it, okay? So let's get started. So this is my calendar view. This is for a month, and let me explain to you this, okay? Let's just say today is August 1st, okay? And I'm talking with someone, and I'm in a meeting, and they ask me for my calendar so they can book a meeting with me, okay? I don't use a calendar. I'm honestly with you. I have a bunch of calendar deals, and I don't use them, because I hate fixed schedules. So how am I gonna fix this? Okay, let's get started by creating our personalized time slots. So in this case, I am going to select availability, and I can click A or click on that button. Everything has a shortcut. That's one of the things I'll talk about in a bit. So okay, so here's by the week view. I can go ahead and change this, but let's just go ahead and select this, okay? So this is today. That's the day, and I am going to select these time frames. Here we go, and I'll select this one also, and this one. I can customize what I have available for the next 3 days, a week, a month, etc., but it's customized. So first of all, it generates this for me, which is the time zones that I'm going to select. Now, I have the option to use this hyperlinked text, which is what you're viewing right now. It can be plain text, and I can use URL only. So I'll use this one because it's gonna be like the most useful one. And let's go ahead and I can invite someone. I can just do it like this and I can hit Command C, okay? In Windows, it's gonna be Control C. Okay, so Command C in this case. And I am gonna go to my Gmail. Okay, and here in Gmail, let's just say I'm talking to someone and I want to share with them my calendar. I'll go ahead and paste this. And here we go. We have available bookings for August 3rd, August 4th, and August 5th at these time zones. And if they click on this, they're going to go to the booking system and they're going to be able to book. Okay, here we go. Here's the time frame available. They can also select from the other days that I selected. This is customized for me. This is personalized. Okay, now that's one of the ways that you could do it. Now, this is just like the icing on the top of the cake. What happens if, okay, I'm in Mexico, I'm in Culiacan, that's what it's called, my city, and the other person that I want to book a slot with is in Paris. So what do we do? Okay, again, so let's go ahead and click A. Get out of here, click A. Let's add some time zones here. And like I said, I'm going to search for Paris. I'm going to select it. And now we have MST and CEST. Which is a time zone in Paris, okay? So now we're working with two, and you can add three and four, okay? Now, you're gonna see that there's a little gray area here, and there's some black. Black means, hypothetically saying, it's like, it's the best time zone for both of us. Obviously, it's a really short block right here, because obviously we're really set apart. And if I add three, four, etc., this block is gonna be changing around. So this is the best time for both of us, which is 8 a.m. and 5 p.m. for them, okay? And this is just a suggestion. It doesn't mean you have to select this. But in this case, oh, that's in the past. I'm going to select this zone and this zone and this zone, okay? Just saying that that's when I'm available for them to book, okay? Now, you can see here that it says this, but I can actually say show every time zone, okay? That means that they're going to be able to view the MST and the CEST time zone. So again, I can go ahead and copy this. Again, I can set all this up, right? I can like the styling, the invite details, the attendees, duration, conference. In this case, I'm using Google Meet. You can use Zoom or something else. Here we go. The calendar that I'm using, which is my personal calendar. I can select another one. And again, Command Z. Let's go back into Gmail and I'm talking with someone, et cetera. And I'm going to share with them my time zone that I'm available for them to book. And boom, they're going to see this, the MST and the CEST. So it's really easy for them to actually understand when the meeting is going to happen for both of us, okay? And again, they're going to select this and go over there, okay? Now, as I said before, I can do this with the hyperlink, plain text, with plain text and URL, the hyperlink text that you saw, the URL only, and it's super easy to do this. And like I said, I can add more time zones. So let's just say that I'm in Culiacan right now, and I'll select something like New York, and someone else from, let's just say Texas. Okay, Texas, whatever, any one of these, okay? So you can see it's saying that this is the best time zone for us to make a meeting. So it's black. So it's pretty cool that we have that option. Like I said, I think that this was actually made for me because that's the way I work. I don't like fixed dates like other calendar apps work. So this works beautiful for me, okay? That's one of the best features that I like about Vimcal. Now, what other things does it have that are pretty cool? All right, so this one's the next one. So in this case, I'm going to create a brand new time slot right here. So I'm just going to select August 3rd, okay, select it here. And then we have this little bar on the top, this little purple bar, violet bar, you could say. Let me show you how cool this is. So I'm going to write something. It's going to be something complex, simple and complex at the same time. So I'm going to say meeting at 3 p.m. with, in my case, I'm going to write for me, Jorge Aguilar. Okay, I'm going to select this one. And for 20 minutes, all right? So that's a simple way. You can see all of this adjusted automatically. You could say that's kind of simple. But then we go a little bit more complex. So we're going to say meeting is going to be held at Starbucks. You can see this right here, Starbucks, Culiacan, which is my city. And I'm getting the search results from Starbucks around here, okay? So I'm going to select that one, okay? Automatically, it's going to auto-adjust everything that we need here based on this, okay? So the meeting is going to be at this time frame, okay, at this place, Google Meet. I can select another one if I like, and I can also add it from the top search to this person, which is my other email account, calendar availability, busy. I can add text to this, the email, minutes, etc. And if I click Command Enter, yes, send, boom. It sent that to them, and it's a done slot, okay? So it has that feature where it's really cool where you just type in all that and it's super easy. Now, let's get into the other features that it has, like simple features that are, we're going to view here that are kind of unique and they well thought out. It's like the user experience was really great when they were working on this. Is if I hover over this, it's going to automatically pop up the meeting information. Now, I'm not going to pop up on the other ones because I have some information there. But it's super easy. Let's go back into the month view, okay? So if I hover over this, there's a meeting there, and it's super easy. Now, one of the things that I really like about Vimcal is that if I click, if I type F, it's going to show me all the commands for the shortcuts. So once you start getting used to using Vimcal, you're going to speed up your workflow, okay? That means that you have the letter there. If I want to go to today, I'll click T. I'm already here, but let's go ahead and jump to November, and I'll click T, it'll jump me back to the day because I know that's a command. Now, again, I can use F to start understanding where these are, and later on, I'll just know by default what letters I need to type. Now, one of the other features that I like about Vimcal, it's they have like kind of like a search, like the finder on Mac. It's Command K, and basically, you can do everything from here also. If you need to find something, if you need to make a meeting, if I need to go to the settings, if I need to time travel, I can scroll through here, or I can just type, for example, settings, okay? And I can go to settings. just like that, okay? There's dark mode, light mode, math OS, my profile, my calendars where I can connect, tags that I need to create, contact groups, up next, etc. This is really interesting, the time zone. So it can select the time zone where I am located. But what if I need to switch this to a permanent time zone? So that means that if I travel, I don't want it to update to that time zone because I'm used to the time zone that I use. Well, I'm going to change it to the one I use, okay? And you can add time zones to this. So select additional time zones to display on your calendar. That's really interesting because if you know that you're making meetings with someone or your team is somewhere else, it's really great to have those time zones available here on the calendar, really easy to view. So a lot of features come into Vimcal. Like I said, this is just like the icing on the cake. I showed you my two favorite features that it has, but there's a lot of things going on in Vimcal that it can do. So you can go ahead and jump and request access and look at all the features that they have. It's fast. They have the AI scheduling assistant. They have the application for iOS. No more mental math. Like I showed you, you can select different time zones and they can view it there. There's the people that you can add here, like better people person, social profiles, do not disturb mode, one view to rule them all. And check this out. I mean, I'd say request access, check it out, and you're going to be blown away with all the features that it has and the time that it's going to save you once you start using Vimcal. Well, that's a wrap for Vimcal.